Yo, 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 it's Big Ant, man. We back. Another edition of Urban Politicians TV. Had to come tap in one time with my boy Trap Genius, man, TG.
Salute, salute.
At This Shit Serious on Instagram, dog. This is probably one of my most special interviews right here. He popped out this weekend at Ace Time, man, to go open up for Maxo Cream. Right. We originally met through Instagram, fucking around on this internet.
For sure.
Doc, hey, he was on lock in the pen. I don't know how we just end up linking up on Instagram. I see this nigga was in the pen making videos and doing music freestyles and everything. Like, I'm like, bro, this nigga active with this rap shit. So I was like, fuck it, I gotta tap in. And then we just developed the relationship and shit. He got out in January. Shit, we rocking now, dog. You out here in Ace Time. We met for the first time in person.
Feel me?
But it was so organic, dog, because it felt like, damn, I don't know why I feel like a nigga been knowing a nigga already. And it's crazy, like they say, like at times, nigga, like you might meet a nigga and you only been knowing a nigga for 2 months.
Right.
But you feel more love and feel like, hey, man, I feel like I'm more solid with this nigga than niggas I've been knowing for 10 years.
Yeah, it always feel like that.
Yeah, it feel like that sometime, bro, in life. And I went through that, you know what I'm saying? Well, hey, I know niggas who I've been knowing forever, and it's like, damn, I don't really feel a genuine side from you, nigga. No vibe, the energy ain't genuine. But with you, shit hit right off the back, man. So introduce yourself, tell them where you from, sure, everything. Man.
First of all, shout out Urban Politics TV, all that, Big Ant. My name TG, I'm from South Central Los Angeles. Out the 40s, you feel me?
Yeah.
Shout Trap out to Genius, everybody call me TG though.
Yeah, for sure, man. Shout out to LA, South Central, dog. We rocking, man.
For sure.
So, tell them, you know, give them a vibe of what it's like, you know, growing up over there, the daily protocol, the daily moving around, the program and things like that.
Really growing up where I'm at, the daily protocol is like, it's like be on 10.
Yeah.
Like, have your surroundings up, you feel me? But it ain't really bullshit like it used to be, but it's bullshit. We still gotta be on your pivot, you feel me?
For sure.
It's more younger, so they more wilder, you feel me? You gotta really watch your back out there, but at the same time, it's pretty decent right now, you feel me? It's a pretty decent time right now.
For sure, that's lit. So, you know, you did say you was from the 40s, was it a...
Yeah.
You know, was it a part of just like everything going around that made you have to make that conscious decision of becoming that, or it's like the way where you was at, you know, hey, this is the culture, you know, because we know LA, the land,
right?
That's part of it, generation after generation.
Right.
You born in it, you don't have a lot of options, you know what I'm saying, at times. So, you know,
it's really like for me, I really lived out of bounds, like. My mom's house is like out of bounds, like from where I'm from now, you feel me?
Okay.
But she passed away and then I moved, you feel me? Once I moved, I started hanging around different people.
So
different people, I made new friends, and these friends was already from this side, you feel me?
Gotcha.
Yeah, they was already from this side.
Yeah.
So like, all right, then I went to a Crip school. So eventually I came Crip, but where I was living, they still fuck with me though. You feel me? Like that's where Joe Mose and them from. Shout out Joe.
Okay.
You feel me? They still like my peoples though. You feel me? They ain't no funk or nothing like that.
Got you, dog. So man, you know, you told me you end up getting incarcerated, you know what I'm saying? And you basically went to prison for a crime you didn't commit.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Basically, just one of my partners made a conscious decision while I was there, really didn't holler in.
Yeah.
So me being the driver put me, I didn't call the Johnny on them, so I'm part of the robbery.
You got me?
So I had to just stay down shitty.
Okay. Damn, that's tough, man. That's tough. Mm-hmm. You did 8 years on that.
Yeah.
And man, to make it clear, bro, I didn't know, cause your energy, dog, it was like you wasn't fucked up, you wasn't depressed.
Nah.
Like, you wasn't like sad, so nigga, I'm like, okay, you in the pen. I'm like, bro, this nigga probably about to get out next year, or he ain't been in there that long.
Yeah.
And you rapping and freestyling, you going outside of every up-to-date beat.
Sure.
I'm seeing you, cause I follow you. I'm seeing you following all the artists I'm following and shit. Like, I see you liking they pics, and I'm like, okay, this nigga here ain't been in there that long. And you tell me, damn, you been gone 8 years. I'm like, damn.
For the real.
How the fuck you so up to date with everything and you know what's actually hot?
I was just like, I would say like a fortunate inmate. Okay. Some inmates be fortunate to have a phone, have people out there who can afford to keep you on, you feel me? Or be a cool dude where you locked in one of your partners in there who got one and you just, y'all just own all the time.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna stay up to date because I like music, you feel me? So I was already competing with motherfuckers before I got out, you feel me? I was like, okay, I gotta do this to even get to the where he at.
For sure.
You feel me? I know I ain't finna go straight to the top, so the people you listen to that's like coming up, them the people I was trying to go at first.
Okay, for sure, for sure. So, you know, you end up getting to that point, and man, I was like, damn, I'm seeing you going off the side of Baby Beats.
For sure.
I'm seeing you basically shooting the music videos, and you got niggas in the background doing this, and now I'm like, bro, this nigga really got this rap shit down on the basic side. Then y'all end up putting a whole mixtape together in that bitch. Sure. And that was a milestone in itself, bro. Cause I say it's a lot of niggas that's free out here, and I see them, bro, and I don't give a fuck how niggas feel about it. I'ma say it for what it is. Niggas bitch, niggas whine, niggas build roadblocks and excuses of why they can't put out music, but you in the motherfucking cage and put out a whole tape.
Sure.
You feel me? And I'm like, bro, niggas out here doing too much complaining. So I was like, you really set the tone for me. Hey, nigga, ain't no excuses in this shit, bro. You gotta boss up and be a motherfucking man and go get it how you live. And y'all did that from that wall. So talk about how that whole process came, dog.
That came about like, just basically like, in the weed game, if you ain't got no pounds, you ain't really the weed man. You feel me?
Yeah.
You just a nigga who sell weed.
Yeah.
But a CD to this rap game is equivalent to a pound. If you got a CD, people will respect it more. I'm saying I'm rapping. People are like, okay, he dropped some little singles. That's like $7. You feel me?
Yeah.
So I needed a whole thing.
Whole project.
I'm serious right now. Not when I get out. I'm not saying when I get out, I'm going to do this. I'm saying right now, I changed to a rapper.
For sure.
So I made a whole CD. We took them risks.
Yeah,
and we made it.
And y'all got it on Apple Music and all that.
For sure. Shout out to Risk Takers.
Yeah, Risk Takers. They had that bitch on Apple Music.
For sure.
You know, put the whole tape. What, like 20 tracks on that motherfucker?
It's 19 tracks.
19 tracks on that bitch. On Apple Music right now. Risk Takers, dog.
Shout out my nigga BG Sinatra, Mr. Unfadable, Munchie TG, my nigga Jay Jonah, my nigga Player Smoke. Everybody on there.
Yeah.
We all took that risk up in there to make that shit.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. Because if they would have, you said if they would have caught you with their phone.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all would've got more time at it and everything.
That's 90 days at it.
Yeah.
The phone 1,000+.
Yeah.
So that's lost. You feel me? So yeah.
Damn.
That's a big risk. You feel me? And that's in a time when I was like a year to the house.
Yeah.
Or 2 years to the house.
Gotcha.
So that's really playing with fire. You
playing
feel me?
With fire. But you did it, man. Pulled it off.
Sure.
That shit down in history. That shit cemented.
Sure.
So now you out here in H-Town. You came home. Let's be the thing. You came home in January. We did an interview right before you came home.
Right.
You came home, got right to it.
Mm-hmm.
I see you going right to the studio. We still keeping in contact. You letting me know what's up. Hey, I got this going. I'm going to go to the studio. You dropped a couple videos out right now. You got the Cam Newton. You got the
Watching Me. Featuring Gutter Soul. That's my bro.
For sure. Got the Watching Me out. You done put consistent tracks on SoundCloud. Matter of fact, give them your SoundCloud too.
Really, my old SoundCloud got corrupted. You know, people hate. You feel me?
Yeah.
Women sometimes. You got to forgive them. You feel me? But my new one, Risk Taker TG, is lit. You feel me?
Yeah.
That MVP, me and Max are on there.
Got you. And you consistently been working. And then you end up coming across Maxo Cream.
Right.
And I've been a fan of Maxo Cream forever. You know what I'm saying? I've always jammed this shit. I'd have been to concerts. The nigga creative as fuck, lyrical as fuck. Different style, whole imagery. Southwest Ace Time. So that was crazy to me. Like, damn, this nigga linked with Maxo. Yeah. You ain't even been out a year yet.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm like, damn, he already linked with Maxo. And then it'd be different if you was doing this before you went in.
Yeah.
You did this shit afterwards. Like, you was working in there. You wasn't a rapper before you went to prison.
Nah, hell nah.
So for you to come right home and not had no nothing, not have nothing, just jump out there and go with it, I feel like you getting your time back. You getting your, this is like God blessing you, giving you that chance, but you earned it.
Yeah.
Wasn't no handouts on that bitch, like, at all. So that's dope, man. And so now you on the tour with Maxo Cream right now. You knocked down the show last night.
Yeah, that motherfucker was crazy. Shout out H-Town. It was going up for me, man.
Yeah, for sure. The energy was good. And you know what's crazy? I ain't gonna lie. On that show, bro, I think what set that bitch off, what niggas took you serious, nigga, is like okay, you got the whole Cali swag, the way you walk, the way you carry yourself.
Yeah.
And when you yanked, when you took off your shirt, nigga, and nigga seen like, damn, this nigga like, you look like a big ass Cali nigga, like, with the tattoo, the way you tatted up, with the, you know what I'm saying, the prison type shit and all that. So then y'all walk a certain way too.
Yeah.
So, you know, they was rocking with you in the beginning.
Yeah.
And like I say, I didn't know Game of Thrones was there. I've listened to it.
Yeah.
You know, I posted up, listened to it, but it was like hearing that motherfucker live.
Yeah.
That shit was crazy. And then like you like got turned up and yanked your shirt off. And I heard like the, I felt the reaction of the crowd, like they was fucking with that, like they knew you and shit.
On
like even though they didn't, then you was like, yeah, neighborhood, they was like, okay, we rocking with this nigga, dog.
They like, it's real, what?
Yeah, they was like, it's real now. That was live, man. That was live as fuck. So shout out to Maxo Cream.
Yeah, man.
You gonna do some more cities, right?
Yeah, I'm finna hit Atlanta on Sunday. You feel me?
Yeah.
I'ma hit basically every city. If we on tour, we doing it.
For sure.
Hey, shout out Maxo, he going crazy. Brandon Banks tour.
For sure.
Appreciate it, man.
For sure. And tell them exactly where they get it with you again on Instagram, everything like that.
Yeah, my IG this shit serious. Yeah. Twitter this shit serious. Snapchat this shit serious. You feel me? Cause this shit really serious.
For sure.
Period.
1,000, man.
Stay real. It's my boy right here.
Yeah, we rocking. H-Time, Texas, man, to LA.
For
all
sure.
Love.
This neighborhood.